Hello there, and welcome back to Brazil. We've got the new chain harrow on the back of the walnut. We're going to head over to the rice field, which is, I believe, field 61. We're going to try it out and do some mechanical weeding. This will be the first time we've used it, first time we've done mechanical weeding here in Brazil. So the walnut at times is really problematic with some mods. I think, if I remember right, when this was brought back to the farm, it was even a little kind of iffy. It was too low, so we'll see if it works. What do we got? I don't have to turn on. Let's lower it down. Seems to be working just fine. Nice to get this before you get any growth. It's easier to see where the weeds are at. You don't miss any. I prefer mechanical weeding to the spray. Although the spray works very well, so if you do miss the opportunity to get them mechanically, so it's good to have the spray as an option. Now, I don't think we have I guess we could use the spreader we use for lime for solid fertilizer. So it's an option for us, I guess. Always an option. Yeah, see, it wants to tell me I don't have access to that land even when I don't have it lowered. Oh, maybe not. Alright. So this is working splendidly. So I've got three fields to do. I've got to do this one here. 62 next door, which we put corn in. And then our barley field in field 69. So I'm going to be weeding for a while. We're finishing up field 62 here with the weeder. You can see just over by our slurry pit, you can see that Bruno is starting to stage his grass equipment. So I think he's going to start working on his field here. So when we get done with the weeding, we'll go over and see if we can help him out. Maybe make a little bit of money. well. Yeah, you can see his mower set up. I think I see his tractor. I think I can see that windrower that he has. I even see his baler behind that. So yeah, he's getting everything over there ready to go. We're gonna start on the bottom, so let's just go up this side here. Oh, I better unfold it first. So we finished 61, I think this is 62, and then we got 69 to go. So this is our barley field. Done before really any of the crop starts coming in. It makes it a lot easier to see where we need to go. Span is not great, you know, the working width on this weeder, but it does a fine job. One more up on back, and one more up on this back side. Should be good to go. Didn't really need to put that down there. Plenty of room to turn around now. My goodness. Finish up here, field 62, and then we're over to field 69. You can see over by our pond and our water tank there. I think Bruno's got all his equipment lined up, even his mechanical bale trailer and everything. So he looks like he's ready to start. We're actually getting through this fairly quickly too, so if we get done in time, maybe we can grab our leased mower set up with our Volta, go over and help them out. If not, we can go over and start helping them with the windrowing and the baling. Looks like I missed the whole section with the planter. Let's see. All right, over to field 69. This is it. at least as quick as spraying it off and without the investment in the herbicide. Sure, we get this field edge here. You know my propensity to mess up this field edge, so we'll overdo it. Probably plenty of room. I am really liking this weeder. It just makes short work of this. Think what? Can I get the whole thing? One more pass on the way up and we're done. Maybe a little bit now. I'll do the edge and then I'll come back to grab those. Hold it up. And that's weeding done on three fields. Pretty quick. Really happy with that purchase. Getting out, pig. Not today. Not today, pig. put this away. I'll look at grabbing the vulture and going down and helping Bruno. See him down there? Got chickens. Alright. So I gotta move that bucket. Just seems like you always put things in the way. I suppose that's kind of what happens when you only really have one building you have everything in. Let's go down, grab the Valtra. We'll come up, we'll grab our mowers. We'll go down and see if we can help them out. Don't see him. Oh, I hear him. Where's he at? There he is. Oh yeah, he's going away. Got his triple mower set up there. Cows heading up to the upper pasture. Got one thinking he's gonna try and escape on me. Here. Down, see if we can help Bruno out down here. He's motoring right along. He's probably about got half the field done already. What we'll do is we'll go down to the far end. A little mess to clean up there. We'll go down to the far end. See if we can help him out. Missed a patch here, Bruno. See if I can get that for him. Nope. I I gotta be careful with my corners because I don't have the mowers set up close together, so when you turn tight, you can end up leaving some grass uncut. Trying to help. This side really that much wider? That road really angle that much from the line he's on? I guess so. When I come to the far end, I'm right next to him, and then on that end back there, pretty far apart. So it's quite the triangle we got going here. Hopefully I won't mess them up. Early in the series, last time we did this with Bruno down here,
trend again. Sit here and discuss how we're going to do this, I think. So let's go talk this out. We gotta make sure that he thinks he's hitting the end. Yeah, I think that did it. Ish. Okay, so Bruno said he would do the wind rowing, and I'm to start the bailing. And then he asked me to not go around the outside because it'll mess him up. just go back and forth. So that's what we're gonna do. Hopefully it'll work out. I suppose it'd be okay to get between these rows, though. We won't be coming back this way. I guess we don't want to get too close to him, though. Otherwise, we'll be waiting on him. So we'll go down here, and then we'll come back and clean up any bits that we missed. Can stay out of his way because he's just coming back now. See if we can get this. That there. This here. Those two bits there. And then we'll just go back and forth. We'll come around the outside afterwards. Otherwise, it's just going to be a mess, right? Still gonna catch up with it quickly, I think. So we'll wait for him. He's going up that side, we'll go up this side. Oh man, we'll be right behind him then. Now we'll have to wait for him again. Yeah. Alright. Nice, we'll make short work of this, working together. What kind of work? Teamwork. So when we get down to the far side, we're going to have to wait for him, I think, so that we've got a complete windrow to work with. We can go over and get those side bits. Wait for him to come back. So I allowed Bruno to get ahead of me because it was just getting kind of problematic over here in the corner with the angles and stuff. So we'll finish up the baling. And he mentioned he had to go take care of something, so we might have to finish up here for him. He was going to leave his equipment here, so we don't have to put the wear and tear on our tractor. So I'm going to finish up baling, and then we'll get on wrapping. He wants to do this for silage. He said we could have some bales. For helping him out. And he's going to give us some money, too. I think rather than hold on to the bales, we're going to take them down, sell them at the biogas plant. It's not where he's selling his, but I think that's what we'll do with ours, because we got like nearly 60,000 liters of silage in our pit. So we're doing okay right now, and I'd like to start working on that and save the bales that we do have for when we try and buy more silage or do more silage, so there's room in the pit. I'm gonna run the outside now. No reason not to. So I think we're going to be wrapping for a while. Okay, we're arriving at Agro Gaucho Bales with the last of Bruno's bales. He asked us to deliver 58 silage bales, wrapped bales, here to Agro Gaucho, and whatever's left on the field we can have. So if you look at the time, it's what, 12:50. We've been working at this pretty much steady at one time speed. It's the thing about baling contracts. They pay well, but they require such an investment of time that it balances out. Same thing with like sugar beet and potato harvest. They pay really well, but they require significant amount of time. Same with like planting potatoes. Just a slow process, and you have to refill the planter. All right, let's deliver these. So that's the contract complete, and we even got paid for a partial for the 50 part of the 58th bale. Probably most of that 58th bale. So we're going to head back to Bruno's field. We're going to collect up the rest of them. He's allowed us the use of his tractor and trailer. And we are going to deliver the remaining silage bales to the biogas plant for a bigger payout than what you get selling them to Agro Gaucho Bales. Plus the bonus of the digestate as a byproduct. Let's try not to dump Bruno's trailer in the bridge the last time we got across it today. We're gonna hustle back to the field and get those remaining bales. So we'll see you in a couple minutes when we get there. Coming up on Bruno's field here. Looks like 4, 8, like 11 or 12 bales we're gonna get. Which is actually, considering how much the biogas plant is gonna pay us, it'll be like $3,600 per bale. That's a lot. That's a lot of corn. At midnight, we should see about, what, 36 grand? Plus, I think Bruno's going to give us 15. That's almost 50 grand. But, like I said, it's a significant investment of time. Doesn't want to pick it up till it gets us tilted up. There we go, that's the last of it. Turn on transport. We will run these over to the biogas plant. driving at the biogas plant
with the 12 bales that Bruno gave us for helping us out, or helping him out. So we'll deliver these. Hopefully without incident. Hole there. We had to push them back a little bit, but took them all. Should see what we get paid at midnight. Bruno said to just go ahead and leave his equipment down in the field, so we'll take it back. Put our mowers, or our leased mowers, away. And I think with that, we've run on long enough, so we're out of time. Thanks for coming back and joining us or visiting us for the first time. Hope you enjoyed it. And hope that you come back and see us again here in Brazil.